I am a sick man, a spiteful man, an unattractive man. That's what I am. I suspect there's something wrong with my liver. But I don't understand a damn thing about my illness. Nor do I know for sure what's wrong with me. I have not been treated for anything and never have been. Though I respect doctors and medical science. Besides, I am extremely superstitious, at least enough to have respect for medicine. I am sufficiently educated not to be superstitious, but I am superstitious. It's because I am spiteful that I don't want to have any treatment. Now, that's something you are probably not inclined to understand. All right, but I do understand it. I couldn't, of course, explain to you who it is that I will actually hurt by my spite. I know perfectly well that I would be quite unable to fold things up for the doctors by not being treated by them. I am aware, no one more so, that all this will harm only myself and nobody else. All the same, if I am not being treated, it's entirely out of spite. There's something wrong with my liver. Well, let it get worse. I have been living like this for a long time, about 20 years. I am 40 now. I used to work in the civil service, but I don't anymore. I was a spiteful civil servant. I was rude and took pleasure in being rude. I never accepted bribes, you know, so I had to find some other reward, even if it was only that. A bad joke, but I won't cross it out. I wrote it because I thought it would be very witty. Now that I see I wanted to show off horribly, I deliberately won't cross it out. When occasionally people came up to my table to ask for information, I used to snarl at them and was delighted every time I succeeded in upsetting them. I almost invariably succeeded. For the most part, they were timid people. Of course, they were petitioners. Among the squankier lot, there was one army officer I particularly detested. He simply refused to do what he was told and rattled his sword in a disgusting way. I waged war on him about that sword for a year and a half and got the better of him in the end. He stopped rattling. Anyway, that happened when I was young. But do you know, gentlemen, the real point about my spite? That is the essence of it, the most revolting aspect of it. It was that I was shamefully aware, even at my most bilious, that I was not only not a spiteful or even an embittered man, but was merely frightening sparrows to no purpose and doing it just for fun. I might be foaming at the mouth, but you bring me some little toy, give me a cup of tea with a touch of sugar in it, and I'll calm down, even be deeply touched. Though later I'll probably be snarling at myself and out of shame, suffering insomnia for months. That's the way I behave, after all. I lied when I said just now that I was a spiteful civil servant. I lied out of spite. I was simply indulging myself with the petitioners and the army officer. I could never really become spiteful. I constantly sensed in myself a great many elements working in the opposite direction. I felt they were just swarming inside me, these opposing elements. And I knew that they had been swarming inside me all my life and were insisting on being let out. But I wouldn't let them out, would not let them out quite deliberately. They tormented me to the point of making me ashamed of myself, having convulsions, till I got tired of them in the end. Goodness, how tired! Doesn't it seem to you, gentlemen, that I am apologizing to you for something? That I am asking you to forgive me for something? I'm sure that's what it seems like to you. But as a matter of fact, I promise you, I couldn't care less even if it does. I have failed not only to become spiteful, but to become anything else for that matter. Vicious or kind, scoundrel or honest man, hero or insect. And now I am living out my days in my corner, taunting myself with the vicious and useless consolation that an intelligent man of the 19th century can't seriously make himself into anything, and that only a fool can succeed in making himself into something. Yes, sir, an intelligent man of the 19th century must be, indeed is morally bound to be, essentially a creature without character. A man with character, a public figure, must essentially be a limited creature. This is my conviction of 40 years. I am now 40 years old. 40 years is a whole life. It is extreme old age. It is indecent to live beyond this, vulgar and immoral. Who lives beyond 40? Answer me sincerely, honestly. I'll tell you who lives beyond 40. Fools and scoundrels do. I'll say this to all those venerable elders, to their face. I'll say it to all those silver-haired, sweet-smelling elders. Yes, to the face of the whole world, I'll say it. I have a full right to say it because I myself will live to 60. I will live to 70. I will live to 80 years old. Hang on a minute. Let me catch my breath. Gentlemen, you probably think I'm trying to make you laugh. You're wrong there too. I'm not at all the sort of jolly fellow you think I am, or as perhaps you think I am. Anyway, if all this chatter irritates you and I feel that by now you are irritated, then just ask me who in fact I am. I will answer. I was a very minor clerk in the civil service, a collegiate assessor. I used to work in order to eat, and for that reason alone. And when, last year, a distant relative of mine left me 6,000 rubles in his will, I retired immediately and settled into my corner. I used to live in that corner before, but now I have settled down in it. It's a rotten room, mine, nasty on the outskirts of town. My servant is an old peasant woman, spiteful because she's stupid, and that's more, and what's more, she always smells. They tell me that the Petersburg climate is doing me no good, and that for someone of negligible means, life in Petersburg is very expensive. I know all that, know it better than all those sagacious and experienced counselors and wiseacres. But I am staying in Petersburg. I won't leave Petersburg. I won't leave it because, it doesn't matter at all whether I leave it or don't. Anyway, what can an honest man talk about with the greatest possible pleasure? Answer, about himself. So, I too will talk about myself.